Here's a study comparing the efficacy and safety of topical permethrin, topical ivermectin, and oral ivermectin in patients of uncomplicated scabies. Ivermectin lotion, which I'd read about elsewhere, so I was kind of interested. And you can see here, it just says that it's an ivermectin powder and lotion base. Ivermectin 1%, here we go, ivermectin 1% lotion was prepared by mixing 1 gram ivermectin powder with 100 milliliters lotion base contains propylene glycol. Okay, so I thought, that's interesting. So then I did a bit of searching around and I found this here's a patent. And, it is assigned to Merck and Company, the people that develop and manufacture ivermectin. And it has the great title of a non-aqueous ivermectin formulation with improved anti-parasitic activity. But it's quite old, you'll see. It's from 1989. And patent's good for 20 years, so what that meant, it expired in 2009. So anybody can use the information in this patent now. Although you need FDA approval to sell stuff as a medicine for humans, of course. So here it describes, in this section here, how to make the ivermectin lotion. Now, ivermectin is also called avermectin. Avermectin is the family that ivermectin belongs to. The avermectin compound is present from 0.1% to 20% by weight. That's an important thing. It says preferably about 1% by weight. Avermectin compound, meaning ivermectin, is dissolved in either glycerol formal or propylene glycol. When dissolution is complete, the remaining solvents are added to prepare the final concentration of drug and ratio of solvents. So let's see if we can do this, children. So here is the lotion that I made. And I'll show you how I made it in a minute. And let me take a little of it here. And you can see it just looks like a regular hand lotion. 100% propylene glycol. Okay, so there's the true complexity of that. And then here I have ivermectin, 10 grams, and let's see if it's veterinary grade, so take that into account. It's 98% plus purity. So I went out and purchased a milligram scale for measuring all this, and that should make it easy peasy. So I folded up a little piece of paper. Okay, so this paper weighs 0.5 grams. I'm only marking that in case I forget later on. But right now, I can press the tear button. And really what that is a zeroing button. So whatever I weigh now, it's not going to take into account this piece of paper. So I'm going to measure out 1 gram of ivermectin. And come on now. Okay, it says I'm just right exactly at 1.0. I'm going to set aside my ivermectin. By the way, before I got started here on camera, I measured how much each squirt of lotion came to, and with this Ziploc container, the bottom weighs 26.1 grams. So now when I toss it back on the scale, I know exactly how much that weighs. Okay, I'm going to measure out some propylene glycol, and I have a nice little Ziploc storage container here. I'll hit the tear button, that zeroes it out, and I just want to have about 20-25 grams of propylene glycol, and you'll see why it's not all that big of a deal how exact I am. Okay, so that says 26.8. I mean, I like using these handy little stir sticks, but you could use a spoon or whatever you want. Okay. Yeah, I feel like if I sort of sprinkle the ivermectin over the surface, it's better than dropping it in one glop. And all I'm doing now is just stirring this up. So this is actually my favorite lotion, Gold Bond, because it's very thick. And if you notice, if I can find it here. Okay, here we go. Propylene glycol, which means that the formula for this stuff has been specifically made so that propylene glycol will mix with all this other good stuff. Right now, this is about 4% ivermectin, but if I top this up to 100 grams, then it will become 1% ivermectin. And remember, what I want to hit is 126, because that'll be 100 grams in this container plus the 26 grams. So I'm at 93. Nice thing about this little scale is I can watch it exactly to see how everything is going. Okay, 127. So if I take out the stick, it goes back to about 122. So right now, what's in this container is going to be 1% ivermectin. It has mixed beautifully. Okay, so it's reading 123.4 just for scientific accuracy. We squirt a little more in, 125.2. I want it to be 126.1. Okay, 125.8. I think I'll have to be satisfied. I'm not a doctor and I'm not a chemist. There are more things I'm not than things I am. There we go. And of course, I'm not telling you what to do with this or what not to do with this. I just got curious about how to mix this up. If you go to my website, click on the link either below in the text or hopefully on screen somewhere here, and I'll describe exactly where I got all the things that you've seen here, and the scale and the ivermectin and the propylene glycol and even the hand lotion. This scale made great things possible. A very accurate scale, and it means I don't have to worry about measuring with teaspoons or anything. Makes everything very easy.